Venom, page 19. If you get stung by a bee. Many folks insist that you must never pull out a bee stinger because squeezing it will pump more venom into you. They advise scraping away the stinger with your fingernail, a credit card, or some other object with an edge. However, in a 1996 article in The Lancet, the British Journal of Medicine, the researchers said that it doesn't matter how you remove the stinger because it pumps through a valve system and not by compression. What is important is that you get that stinger out fast so it stops pumping, period. Whether you've been stung by a bee or wasp, you should wash the area and then put ice on it to reduce swelling and pain. Calamine lotion, calendula gel, or other itch pain-relieving creams may also help. Some people use tea bags, baking soda paste, or meat tenderizer, which contains papain, an enzyme that breaks down the toxins in the venom. Wasp wasted. Wasps and bees are close relatives. In fact, bees and ants evolved from wasps. Usually less hairy than bees, wasps are known for their very narrow waists between the thorax and the abdomen. They do not make honey or wax, and they have smooth stingers, which means they can sting over and over without dying. The wasps we most often encounter are the social wasps, creatures that live in groups, such as hornets, yellow jackets, and paper wasps. All of them make different types of papery nests, sometimes in troublesome places, such as on door hinges, inside porch lights, or under tables. Disturb a well-developed nest and you could get zapped. Solitary wasps, critters that live alone, can also sting in self-defense, but they mainly use their venom to paralyze spiders or insects. Like bees, these wasps feed largely on nectar when they are adults. As babies, they need a lot more protein, and that means meat. The great golden digger wasp will sting prey, such as a katydid, and then drag the victim into its burrow nest in the ground. The tarantula hawk, aka tarantula wasp, a desert species, will attack a tarantula many times its size, paralyze the spider, and manage to lug it to the spider's nest, or sometimes the wasp's own burrow. This wasp sting is especially painful to people, though not lethal. A potter wasp or a mud dauber wasp carries its prey, a spider or insect, depending on the wasp species, into its pot or pipe-shaped clay nest, which is often found on buildings. Then the wasp lays an egg, generally on the prey. When the egg hatches, the larva eats the meat. The paralyzed but still living prey is not only high in protein, but also fresh. Hornet, paper wasp, potter wasp.